Today I want to share with you why I'm so excited about Excel's new checkbox feature. And yes, I know Excel already has a checkbox feature available, but this new update has been long awaited and much anticipated. Let me show you. So here we have a habit tracker that we're going to fill out for the week using our new checkbox feature. Now, just so you understand how happy I am about this new feature, let me show you the old way I would do this. So normally if I wanted to insert a checkbox, I would go under this developer tab. If you don't have the developer tab, you can customize your ribbon to show it, but you would just go under insert, insert a checkbox, and we would place one there. I would remove the text and center that. Now I could just copy the checkbox down and across and that would be fine. But we want to apply a calculation to show the progress as we go through the week. And to do that, I need to link the checkbox to the cell. So what I would do is right-click, hit Format Control, and then for the cell link, I would just select the cell that it's in. Click OK. Seems easy, right? Well, and then you would just take that and copy it down, and you've got your checkboxes filled. The problem here, though, is when I check one off, all of them get checked off. That's because the cell link is tied to this one cell at the top. Now you could go into the format control for each checkbox and change the cell link, but for a range larger than this, that gets to be a bit of a headache. So let's go ahead and delete these. And I'll show you the new checkbox feature. Now you may have noticed this checkbox option here under my developer tab. That is the new checkbox tool. You can also find it under the insert tab. However, I should mention that this is currently in beta version, so in order to get this, you have to subscribe as a Microsoft 365 insider. It's not going to cost you anything. You can do a quick Google search on the instructions, but simply, you're just going to go under File, go to Account, and you'll see this Microsoft 365 Insider. I'm already signed up, but you would see an option to sign up for this Insider program. Just make sure that when you do sign up, if you sign up, you choose the beta version, or else you're not going to see that checkbox. So let's go back to our habit tracker. Now, one of the best things about this new tool is it's such a time saver. Instead of inserting a checkbox one by one or copying it across and then changing the cell link, I can just select the range I want the checkboxes to be in. And again, I'm under my insert tab, click checkbox, and there they are. Simple as that. Now I can check them off individually. They are listed as true and false statements, so I don't have to worry about format control or cell links. You can even customize these and change their colors. To change the color, you would just go under the Home tab, and under the font color, you could change them to whatever you'd like. Now, the one thing that's a little bit different about this is you can't just delete these. You see, it looks like it's gone, but if I click back into the cell, it reactivates. So what you actually have to do if you want to get rid of your checkboxes is delete them there, and we go back to the cell, go to clear, and you would clear formats. And now there's no checkbox in there. Now you could do this for one cell individually, or you could apply it to an entire range. It's really up to you. But let's go back. We do want our checkbox. Now let's make our habit tracker just a little more functional. We can show our progress of our habit tracker by using a count if and count a formula at the bottom here. So if I want to track Sunday's progress, I would just enter the count if formula, select my range, and we only want to count those that are true or checked. Now let's divide that by the count a function, which is going to count all the active cells in our range with values. Hit enter, and we have 30%. Go ahead and copy that formula over, and now let's change it to a percent, and let's center that up. So now we can track the progress of our habit tracker throughout the week. Now we can take it a step further and apply some conditional formatting to make this pop just a little bit more. So let's select our range of checkboxes, and under conditional formatting, we'll make a new rule. We'll format only cells that contain, and we'll set the cell value equal to true. So if a checkbox is checked, it will activate the conditional formatting. And what we want to do is change the color of the checkbox, which would be the font color. So let's change it to kind of a bold green. So as each checkbox is checked, we get our little indicator that progress has been made. Now we can apply another conditional formatting rule, check each habit throughout the week. If every box has been checked, we could strike through our habit, letting us know that we've completed it and we did a great job. So go ahead and select your habits. We'll create a new rule. This time we want to enter a formula. And the formula we want to use is our same count if count A formula. We'll select our range, which would be the row, set that to true, and divide that by the count A of the same row. This time, we want it to equal 1 to activate our conditional formatting, and 1 would be equal to 100%. Now, one more thing here. We don't want absolute references for our rows because we want this to follow all the way down the tracker. So go ahead and get rid of those dollar signs. Now we can format. And this time, under the font tab, just go ahead and click strike through. So as each row is complete, we'll strike through the name of the habit to signify its completion. Hit OK. And let's test it out. There you go. We made our bed every day of the week. It's right in our gratitude journal. All right. Perfect. Now, one more thing I want to show you. We could take this a step further and include a chart. I think that'll give us a little more motivation to complete our habits throughout the week. So let's go up to Insert. Let's insert a bar chart. So we'll go to Select Data under our Chart Design tab, and we'll add a new series. And our series value will be our percentages. Click OK, and we'll edit our access labels. Okay. So let's get rid of our chart title. Maybe we can format this a little differently. Make this a little smaller. Do a little more formatting. Format our data series. And let's give it a little bit of different color. Go with that. Let's fix our axis. Set the maximum to 1 for 100%. And let's reorganize this. Categories in reverse order, so it'll match our habit tracker. Set that up a little bit, move it over. There you go, looks pretty good. Now, do you see why I'm excited about this new feature? This should make everything you want to do with Checkbox within Excel run much more smoothly and more efficiently. So tell me in the comments, are you as excited as I am? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.